The Snody Highroller. When I initially borrowed this knife, I went in with low expectations. let me tell you, this thing is something else. A couple of things about the Highroller really stood out to me. First and foremost, the pivots, they have a hexagon design which prevents them from slipping when you're trying to tighten or loosen the balisong, whereas other handles, you would have to squeeze the handles together and hope that they don't slip. But the hexagon design in the back really, really improves upon that weakness for most other balisongs. The horns, as aggressive as they look, they don't pinch. They're horned close enough to the handle to where you really have to jam your finger in there in order to pinch yourself. The swedge on the spine of the blade tapers out towards the tip of the blade, which gives it a bit better balance. The Highroller is a tad handle heavy, but it does not affect any of the flipping that you do with it, although because of the piss poor latchless design, I wasn't unable to test many aerials with it because latchless. Criticism time. Most channel titanium balisong especially have kickers and kicker pins within the design. This thing instead has two tang pins. Not quite sure how I feel about that. Tang pins or just one more thing to go wrong with the knife. Kickers and kicker pins prevent that. And it really is good at everything. Everything except treating your wallet. Price is a bit over the top. I understand why he calls it a Highroller. Sitting right around $800, you have to be a Highroller to buy this thing. No ordinary flipper will ever be able to afford this thing without it being given to them. It's really balanced for everything. Ladders, rolls, taps, transfers, whatever. It's great. This thing has a marvelous balance to it. I highly recommend it for people that flip of any caliber. The blade is a bit longer, which disallows me to add a sweet tactical latch like I am on most other latchless knives. And I'm not sure if he didn't add a latch because he's lazy or he's ignorant on the design of the latch, but it's the same thing as buying a car without a spare tire. If you want a Kia, fine, go buy a Kia. I don't get it. People that do want to flip without a latch are competent enough to remove it themselves. Balisong need a latch. This thing is sharp. I've cut myself more with this thing than I think I have any other knife ever. Simply dropping it, I sliced my shin open one day. It's sharp and it holds the edge. It doesn't go away if you cut yourself one time. And again, the pivots, they hold well. They don't twist. There's no turning. The hexagon design allows for easy maintenance and upkeep. That's great. I really, really love that about this thing. Now, the two tang pins, I still find that strange because most channel titanium balisongs have one tang pin with kickers. Though, of course, the kickers wear out and all, but tang pins wear out faster. The tang cups wear out faster, the tang pins fall out, and there's no easy fix for that. So if the tang pins fall out, which there's two of them on here, two of which could likely fall out, we have to send it back to the manufacturer or creator or whatever, artist, to get them fixed. And I highly dislike the two tang pins.